Things like you do, God, I love you. title in my translation is Tell the Coming Generation. Tell the Coming Generation. Give ear, O my people, to my teaching. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth, and I will speak my mouth, or I will open my mouth in a parable. And I will utter dark sayings from of old, things that we have heard and known that our fathers have told us, and we will not hide them from our children. But tell to the coming generation the glorious deeds of the Lord and his might and the wonders that he has done. And as I was praying that, the Lord showed me the coming generation. And the coming generation isn't just based on age. Because I saw the young and old who have been in the dark coming into the light. The coming generation are those who will come into our body and who will be entrusted to us to bring them into the fullness of who they are in Christ. The coming generation says two things. There's a generation to carry this on, and it's coming.
Continue with some worship, so feel free to stand or sit or do whatever you want to engage.
Spirit calls my heart.
ministry in the house of God. I trust in the steadfast love of God forever and ever. I will thank you forever because you have done it. I will wait for your name, for it is good in the presence of the godly.
Good morning. again. There are more of you now. So for those of you that weren't here for the first good morning, I'm going to say it again. Hey, if the men and women will come forward, we'll take up this morning's tithes and offerings. Father, we thank you. Wow. Everything we have is yours. Lord, just thank you that you give us so abundantly. And even in the difficult times that we go through, Lord, that you are always there and always faithful. We love you, Lord. Amen. I'm going to run the announcements, and then at the end of the announcements, usually we say get up and greet each other. We don't want you to do that this morning, okay? So stay in your seats.
Hi, I'm serious. My name is Cindy West, and these are the announcements for Sunday, September 17th. On Friday, September 22nd, the Women's Fellowship will meet at 7 p.m. Heidi Alvarado will speak. Yay. Check your bulletin for the deets, which rhymes with teeth. Brush your teeth.
I think there's the perception that women's group is all about tea and roses and floofy girly stuff, but it's really about a time to connect with the other women in our church, to hang out, get to know one another, and then one of the women will share her story so that when you see her at church, you see the person because you know her story. It's one of the reasons why I'm willing to share my story. It's not exciting, it's just my story, but that's just it. My story, your story, it's our story. I think that's what Women's Fellowship is all about.
Amen. Completely separate from the women's meeting is our men's women's brunch. On Saturday, September 30th at 10 a.m., it's almost full up, so sign up today. BYOB, bring your own bacon. The women's brunch starts at 10 a.m. BYOB.
Cindy, cut! All right, guys, let's review. Flowers, check. Tea, check. Tablecloth. Check. Quiche.
Check.
Where's the quiche?
It's right here.
Nice, Aubrey.
What's with the mustache?
Paul and Barnabas group meets today from 11:30 to 2 p.m. Come and fellowship with those in our missions community.
Yes.
On Tuesday, September 26th, from 7 to 9 p.m., the Cordies will host the ministry team training. We'll introduce you to the way we approach prayer ministry and feed you yummy dessert, floss provided. Please RSVP to Lori Cordy and check your bulletin for more info. Beginning Wednesday, September 27th through November 8th, from 7 to 9 p.m., the Driscolls will lead the New Life Breaking Free Inner Healing Study. This study equips people with practical healing tools through the authority and promises of Jesus. Did I mention that you can check the bulletin for more information? You can. If you're new here or visiting us today, thank you for choosing to spend part of your Sunday here with us in Adventures in Odyssey. We invite you to Connection Table, Patio, Portico, any way you head. After service points to the right, visit the yellow table, and we would love to see you. More about our church now. Take a moment to greet the people around you and tell me what to do with my hands.
Yeah, she is. And she's actually a miracle. She's married to you. God does answer prayer. That's an incredible thing. I've had the worship team stay back up here for right now because in the Bible, it talks about offering up a sacrifice of praise. And So I thought, though, this is a very good opportunity to do that. Because there are people here that are suffering from all kinds of things. You wouldn't know it by looking at them or talking to them briefly, but they have severe problems in their families. They have severe problems at work. They have severe problems with their health or friends or whatever that. And so what a sacrifice of praise is praising the Lord in spite of the circumstance. It's really wonderful to get a bunch of Christians together and go to a convention center and all worship your heart out. But you need to be able to worship your heart out when you don't sense His presence, when you don't, when nothing's going the way that you think it should. And so we're going to stand and we're going to do that. And so we're going to do it. Stand. Wherever you want.
Yeah.
publicly. That we need you. And we pray, Lord, that you would, by your Holy Spirit and by your word, speak to our hearts and our lives, encourage us and strengthen us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So if you ever trying to figure out what a sacrifice of praise is, and you're tempted to go to the internet or go to a commentary or any of those things, you already know. What you just did is it's praising God in the midst of the storm. It's like Jesus said about loving. It's easy to love people who love you. And it's easy to praise God on the mountaintop. But it's not easy to praise him when you're in the valley and in difficulty. And so that's what we need. I have a friend, David Parker, pastor of the largest Vineyard church in California and probably one of the largest Vineyard churches in the United States. And he has an illness. He's got cancer of the blood vessels, and there's no known cure. Nobody's ever been cured of it. They prolonged their life as many as 5 years. But David's a brilliant man and articulate person and a very, very dear friend of mine and his children. And so anyway, I was on the phone with him and I said, listen, I just want you to come. I just want you to come and expose our people, to your teaching. I mean, he's a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant teacher. And he's a wonderful, compassionate, loving man. When I visit him, he's got a freaking brain tumor, he had this thing cut out and all that stuff. And, he's helping me in my chair and he's pulling his car up so I don't have, he does all these things. I go, I just had a stroke, you have a brain tumor, so, you don't need to worry about me, but he's just that kind. Anyway, he's coming on the 15th, October 15th. And he's gonna bring his worship leader. She asked me separately. I mean, I've asked her to come because I was there one time and I thought she was wonderful. So I said, "Why don't you come? Want to come to and lead worship for us?" And it's very, very easy to entice people that are from Lancaster, the upper desert, to come and be with us. That itself is a treat. So anyway, so she said yes, and then I just talked to David yesterday, and so he gave me a date of October 15th. And you're not going to want to miss it. And we'll adjust our whole service towards him. There will be two things, worship and his teaching, and then a ministry at time at the end. But his teaching is so rich and so deep and so profound that you'll be really truly amazed. And he knows how to give a price, sacrifice praise. He continues to pastor. He continues to lead people to Jesus. He continues to walk with the Lord. And that's going to be a great, great treat for us to have him. So, there's a couple other things I need to do. Last Thursday, I was at an area pastors meeting for Vineyard churches and at VCC, and our area pastor is a guy named Mike Safford, and he's a senior associate of Anaheim Vineyard. And he asked me to come up and share a little bit about my book, and so I did, and briefly, and then Mike kept talking as he does, and wait till we have him come. We don't really have time for prayer. He announced to everybody there that they're making arrangements at this point in time. To have me come and share my story at Anaheim. And if you know my story at all, that began at my sister's house. And so that's really redeeming. It's very restorative for that to happen. And if it is a Sunday morning, we're going to talk to Dom. We're just going to we're going to cancel service here and have the service up there. And we'll hand you special envelopes that you can put your tithe checks in. So. They don't get any dime from us, you know. Not one thin red dime. And I'm not bitter. But I know how much money they have, and I know how much money we have. So, frankly, he said they're making arrangements right now, and it doesn't mean it's going to happen. I mean, there's a lot of things people intend to do that they don't do. And so I just take it, the fact that they are wanting to do that is a kind thing and a healing thing and frankly, appropriate thing. But they don't have to. I'll be okay, yeah, if they do or they don't. But I think they're going to. And so when that's going to happen, I'll announce it. And I would be really fun for me to have you there. So. All right, I'm going to get into my message.